Okay, it is 1 week earlier than usual. Time for a Shroud of the Avatar pre-alpha release. We're at R24 now, which means there's been 2 years. 2 years of monthly releases. Oh, there's a guard who I don't know the name of. Yep, 2 years of monthly releases. If you were watching my videos previously, you will be aware that this release is early due to Thanksgiving next week in America. So there's only been 3 weeks to work on stuff, you know, compared to the usual month. So there isn't as much new stuff in this release as what we've grown used to. So I've started at my house here, and the reason I've started is the replenishing snowball box and the ice and box of plenty, both of which for me are whatchamacallit rewards, because of benefactor rewards. Is that the phrase for what I'm looking for? Up until now, they have merely been decorations. In this release, they are actually functional. Although, I've not actually made them function yet. So they are allegedly functional. The way they work, so the snowball box is supposed to get 50 snowballs every winter that you can use. Oh, someone's kissing passionately, which is interesting. What I'm not sure about is when the winter starts. So I'm assuming... so here we are in winter, look. I'm assuming it's winter in Earth, and it possibly won't be having anything in it until after Thanksgiving. So all I've got from it so far is this replenishing snowball box doesn't seem to be doing anything. The artisan box of plenty is so far unresponsive, but I'm pretty sure it's supposed to give me a crafting ingredient once a day. So these are both supposed to be working in this release. I can't demonstrate that yet. I will keep trying, and hopefully if they do something, I will have recorded it and could upload it. So the next interesting thing might be a bit hard to see here in the dark, but we have clockwork dogs and cats. There he is by the fire, walking around. He's stuck in a corner already. He's standing on the chest. Now I had a cat from last time. Can I not put the cat in the same room as the dog? Perhaps not. Interesting. So let's put the cat upstairs. Why not? I can't put the cat upstairs, so maybe I can only place one pet at a time. Let's try it in a room by itself. Ugh. Am I in a room? Yes, I'm in a room. No. So possibly I'll put the cat in the basement. But you saw the cat in the last release if you watched my first look video there. Where's the dog gone? He's got on top of the chest, he's stayed there. Not the smartest, definitely not. So there is, at the level I'm at, I have a full set of clockwork pets and a full set of you know, live pets, which I can place in my house. I also have, if I find it in my inventory, I'm carrying a load of crap around just in case I wanted to demonstrate it. Alright, so I've got a brass clockwork dog call. So if I, this is the minute I've got my chest mimic. No. Alright, down here. There we go. Requires one brass clockwork dog call, one remaining. So let's just fire him up. So now I've got two. I've got two brass clockwork dogs. There you go. Now it's not a combat. It's not a combat pet. It won't. Ooh, teleport pet. Interesting. It won't join in any fights or really do anything useful. But it'll look quite natty as you wander around town. So we've got two dogs, both really keen to get into the corner for some reason. I'm not sure what's over there. Maybe a squirrel. Or a clockwork squirrel. Who can say? Who can say? I might as well put my chest movement back while I'm at it. There. Let's go. So then there's one more item. I'm going to show you while I'm still here at home, and that's my ancestor tombstone. Let's stick it over here against the wall. I can't stick it against the wall because it's too tall. I'm guessing. Maybe I have to put it outside. But tombstones. One of the rewards. Oh, I should open the door so my dog can get out. One of the rewards is to have your name on a tombstone. Where's it gone? No, I can't place it anymore. In game, I suspect I need to have a garden of some sort to be able to place it at this point. It's just not working, is it? So, decoration. Can I place it in there still? No. So it's probably an outdoor decoration, and I've not got a garden, so I can't show you up close. But yes, that's what I was saying. Come on, dog. Where's my dog? Come on. You. Teleport pet? Interesting. So can I do that out here? Teleport pet. There we go. I've got him outside at least. So yes, tombstones I was talking about. There is actually... Where's my pet gone? Oh, there he is. Yeah, he's running up and down. How sweet. There is... in this release a graveyard containing the tombstones for all those people that back to the level that get their get to place an ancestor name on their on a tombstone in game. He's fast, that doggy, eh? Fast. So the graveyard, I've checked that what's on the grand tour, the graveyard is part of the grand tour, so I'm planning to do the grand tour later, and so we'll see it then. In fact, quite a lot of the new things in this release are on the grand tour because there are several new areas. Here comes my dog. There are several new areas, and I'm not going to do them now. I'm going to do the grand tour. So while we're standing here in the rain, which you'll notice, This is another new feature. The weather itself was introduced, I think, one or two releases ago. It's been expanded in this release in that the weather will follow seasonal patterns. You'll get more rain in autumn, and also it will follow the the scene. So in high cold places, you'll get snow instead of rain. So there's a few basic types of weather. There's sort of windy, rainy, clear and sunny. But those will present in different ways in different scenes. For extra realism. I don't know if it'll have any effect on gameplay. No one's mentioned anything. You know, it'd make it more difficult to stand on cobbles in the rain and fights, so to speak. But I guess not. Right, so my plan here is to head out and find some combat. So we'll pass by Berard and into Novia. Let me just review what's gone on my to-do list of things to talk about. I'll just talk about the weather, so I can tick that off. So I talked about the clockwork cats and dogs. Also in this release, horses and pack animals. Now these are both part of stretch goals, which you can pledge for on the site. Actual interactive horses you can ride, and pack animals you can put your gear on. These are both things that are stretch goals. But the creation of the creatures, the models, that's already happened, and they're now in game in this release. So somewhere around here, there will be some. Somewhere around here there will be some. That's what I was looking for. East Perennial Trail. Let's go into that and beat up some low-level characters. There will be horses and donkeys. There are also for some seasonal creatures, turkeys and reindeer that are basically pets, much like the clockwork dog. They're also purchasable in the add-on store. Alright, where am I? Max DeMille and his Breath of Fire. Let's see if we can find something to kill. So, there have been some combat balance changes. Mostly these are that the chance of a critical hit has gone up when you're using your skills from the action bar in a fight. This is slightly up for melee actions, but it's like a massive 50% boost for magic actions. So I'm going to see if I can find anything at all to fight. There we go. Let's go for it. Let's switch to my combat tab. Did I do anything? Oh, look, 48 point of critical damage. There we go. Let's trip him. Didn't work. Let's trip him again. That worked. So there were some quite big numbers scrolled past up there. Oh, 2-8, he's already dead. And as you can see, this is a low level area, so I'm quite comfy. But, oh, there's another skeleton. Let's go. Let's go, you. Let's watch out for some critical damage stuff going on. Let's do that one. 46 points of critical damage. There you go. I wiped him out with a double slash. So you can see it has had an effect. It will change the combat a bit in that you now will have to be using your skills to have the maximum effect rather than just leaving it all at attack and healing every now and again. While we're talking about skills, let's just look at some of the new things under Subterfuge. So this was here already, isn't it? Right, what we're getting in this lease is pickpockets. It's no good to me, of course, because I'm not in PvP. But you can attempt to pick the pockets of other PvP players. The rewards, I presume, will be quite good. But also, if you get caught doing it, so if someone spots you attempting to pick their pockets and clicks on you, you will suffer like tremendous damage. Oh, there's a bandit. Let's go and kill him. You'll suffer tremendous damage, which might be hard to recover from. We won't really see how it works until well, I guess unless I do a PvP, which, to be honest with you, is unlikely. I might do it in my basement at some point just to see what it's all about. What's he doing? You got some gold, I'll take it. So, that's the combat stuff. While I'm talking about the pickpocket, there is in this release, if you're into PvPing and all that sort of thing, a feature called ransom proofing. So the way the PvP works is when you defeat someone, it sort of picks an item at random, and that goes into a sort of exchange thing where you can either pay to get it back or let the opponent claim the reward for defeating you. The ransom proofing is it means that things that are pledge rewards or other things that you've paid for, add-ons or mission items, I'm guessing, they can't be ransomed in the PvP stuff. This will almost certainly enrage some of the pure full loot PvPers, I'm sure. But I'm sure equally it's gonna make some people who have spent a lot of money on stuff quite happy that it can't be getting nicked, and they can still do PvP. So there's not that much more to talk about in this release. I'm gonna head into Soul Town just to show you a few more things, and then I'm gonna head out to Hometown. I'll explain this a bit more in a second. Let's just get in. Alright, so I'm going to charge into the centre of town because there'll be a crafting table there. So crafting has had some improvements in this release. One of the improvements is that crafting tables are now of varying quality. For the public ones you find just lying around, they're all going to be the lowest quality crafting table you can get. Ooh, look at all the guff he's got. So it's possible if you can get onto someone's lot. So this might be interesting. Let's see if he's got a better quality crafting table. No, I can't use it because it's private. Will be interesting all the same. Anyway, let's head into... So I'm not sure how this crafting stuff is indicated to you, so I'm just going to charge in and double click on something and see what happens. If we get any sort of indicator, get the usual crafting lag. Stuff will pop up any second now, he says confidently. There we go. So, okay, so there's no real indication of what's going on with that, but I can tell you it's there. The higher quality crafting stations will increase your chance of succeeding in the recipe. Now you'll see here there's now percentages next to the recipes as the skill level now factors into how successful you'll be. How successful you'll be at crafting an item. So that's... Oh, I'm pressing the wrong button. So that's that's all coming together, bit by bit. We're getting an interesting crafting system. So now I am just gonna go here, and we'll notice there is no tour guide standing in his normal spot. He is absent. So we're gonna chat to the sales automaton about it and find out that he's gone to hometown. So hometown, if you'll tell us where it is. Yep, it's an island run by the Novia Grand Tours agency and realty company, Marcus Gorn proprietor. Its star attraction is the Parade of Homes, a showcase of all the finest architecture available. Blah 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 blah. Right, so that's where the Grand Tour starts in this release. So I'm going to head out that way, just to, I'm not going to do the Grand Tour in this video, but, you know, it'll be a sort of seamless transition. While I run out of Soul Town and trundle across the map, I'll talk about, what else have I still got to talk about? Well, I mean, there are a bunch of new player run towns in this release. If you check the update email, if you're a backer, the update email has a map of all the player-owned towns that are now in the game, so you can visit them. As part of the sort of crafting and resource harvesting improvements, fishing is now more effective in the mornings and the evenings than it is during the middle of the day or the middle of the night. I guess this reflects upon, you know, that's what real fishing is like. I can't tell you, I've not done a lot of real fishing myself. Not in 25 years or so, anyway. And when I did it, I was not successful. Maybe I was doing it at the wrong time. So, hometown is east of Soul Town. So there we go, get the big E. And it's on the island there. I'm gonna head over there and I'll finish off this video. There we go, double click on it when the arrow goes green. I'll finish off this video by having a quick run round, and we'll look at all the pretty houses. I guess if you're not interested in the pretty houses, you can probably just stop watching at this point, but that's what I'm gonna do anyway. Doesn't bother me. Like I said, it's only been 3 weeks, so there's not a lot of new stuff in this release compared to the previous release. It's also not that it's not been optimized like they hoped. They were aiming R24 to be one of the releases where they do a lot of back-end optimization work, but with it all being cut a bit short, they've got rid of all that. Right, so the tour guide is actually behind that podium there. Let's just have a look. So there is an airship up there. Lighthouse. Oh, castle is loaded in. So I might try and head up to the airship, because that is a new feature. It's in the add-on store. There's a tour guide in his bonnet. We will come back and see him later. And we'll head up the hill. And we will see the many available house designs. There's quite a nice one over there, like the, you know, the sort of Disney castle style thing. Just around the corner here. Look at that. And before everything loads and obscures it, there's a bunch of decorations here in the centre of town. It's all going to take quite a long time. I'm imagining this is a fairly heavy duty scene as far as amount of crap it has to deal with. A nice dragon statue. Oh, picket gate. Nice. So like I said, there's an obsidian keep. That's is that a longhouse or something? I'm going to try heading up towards that hot air balloon. I think, oh, there's my house is over here, look. One's a three-story one. Three-story blue tile? Maybe. Let's trundle off this way towards the airships. The airship home, which, you know, is pretty cool in and of itself, that you live in an airship. It's kind of weird though, in that it still sits on one of your regular, I think it's a village lot, or perhaps the next one up from that. So, it's going to be possible for people in the middle of, say, Arteris, to have an airship home, which is going to look a bit weird, I would say. I don't know whether they're ever going to place restrictions on that. I mean, you don't know whether they should, really. Because clearly some people just love doing ridiculous things. Other people find that their immersion is spoiled by ridiculous things appearing in the world around them that people have put there. It's one of those things, really, isn't it? Because these people have paid their money. Ooh, boat. These people have paid their money, and you know, in many ways, they can do what they like. There we go, into the airship. And other people just get over it, perhaps. I don't think we'll really have an answer. But anyway, there I am in an airship. This is in the add-on store. Well, it's not an airship, it's not an air balloon, isn't it? In the add-on store, if you've got a garden to tether it in, which I haven't. But look, what excellent views, my lord. Oh, weird camera mechanics again, but there we go. So that was most of the new stuff in Shroud the Avatar R24. I will head back down the hill to the tour guide and attempt to do a video. If you're in a rush, Invico Gaming has already done his tour guide video. He's quick off the mark, that lad. And you should go and check that out straight away if you're interested in getting the Pilgrim Bonnet Grand Tour reward for R24. Anyway, that's it from me for now. Shroud the Avatar R24 release.